in 25 years of teaching, just suddenly the lights go on. The children just come alive. Children who are very quiet, usually don't talk very much, are exploding. You know, they're almost pulling on you. Sir, sir, look at this. Sir, sir, let me tell you. Look at what I've built. Look what happens if you do this. Sir, did you know this? And it's electric. If that's going to mean those children are engaging in learning, thinking, talking, upskilling, yeah, let's set Wales on fire with Minecraft.
If I could be that role model for younger girls especially, to be like, I want to be like them when I'm older, you know, have like that confidence and that ability to show that you're good in something, and I think that's very amazing.
I've taught my other friends how to code, and when they didn't know how to move, I taught them how to move. It makes me feel excited and kind and proud of myself.
We as a nation have made Minecraft Education Edition available to all learners, to all teachers, to all schools, and we've provided a package of support and training for teachers to appropriately use it then in the classroom. I'm really proud that Wales is one of the top utilisers of this tool for learning. Initially, we chose 5 schools from across all areas of Wales to ensure that we had that national coverage. And these were schools that had showed some real promise, so we wanted to use that, harness that, and build upon that to then begin to develop a programme that could be delivered across other schools across Wales.
The Minecraft Learning Centres really were developed to support teachers. It was an opportunity for those to share the good practice, but in a structured way, so starting with the basics, you know, how to use Minecraft as a tool, how to move around, how to navigate, then moving into how you can use Minecraft to develop the curriculum for Wales and thinking about how it could be used to support different AOLEs.
The most challenging part is getting teachers to take that first step. It's taking a chance, giving it a go with your learners. I think that's been quite challenging, but I think from a teacher's perspective, I want to know, well, how can I use it? I've used it for teaching wellbeing, for teaching maths, creative writing, history. Pretty much every lesson we've managed to incorporate Minecraft into it because it's such an engaging tool that it just brings the lesson alive.
I think as soon as myself and Barry had gone on that initial training and the pupils had heard that we'd been on the training, we were the coolest people in the school. You know, we were walking through the corridors like, oh yeah, and they were looking, you know.
We started with 5 schools, with 5 centres in the first year. In the second year, then we moved that up to 10. And we're now in the third year, and we've got more online virtual trainers who are providing peer-to-peer support, electronic digital support across the country.
In the initial stages, each Minecraft Learning Centre worked with a Microsoft global training partner, really until they were confident at delivering the programme themselves. This really upskilled them in terms of confidence, and it was great to sort of start with that sort of hand-in-hand approach. And now the Minecraft Learning Centres are just sort of flying, they bring in their own unique perspective, and it's really helped develop confidence, knowledge and expertise.
There are 4 purposes at the heart of everything across the continuum of learning from age 3 to 16 that a learner should be doing. They are that we want learners to be ethical, informed citizens of Wales and the world, enterprising, creative contributors ready to play a key part in life and the world of work, that they'll be healthy and confident individuals ready to lead fulfilling lives, and that they will be ambitious and capable learners and ready to continue learning after that school age as they then go on into later life. It's a fantastically exciting time in the education space in Wales, and we have a massive opportunity now to tailor education that is meaningful for learners, to ensure that equity across the country, that all learners have equal opportunities and equal outcomes through their learning, but also to make fundamental change and to think about not what we want learners or children to learn, but how we want them to learn.